Hello and welcome back to Kona part 2 of this game. Last time we started the game, we got into a car crash. We ended up in deep winter all of a sudden, and we found the general store, but our client was dead. So now we're gonna try to figure out what the hell happened here. And as far as I remember, we still have to get gas for my truck here. And let's see if that works now. So I think that's the last thing I have to do at the store.
The pumps wouldn't surrender their divine nectar so easily. In all likelihood, they had to be switched on from inside the store.
I already thought I did switch the pump on, but I guess I didn't. Or they came out, they must have come off when I actually tinkered with the power switch here. Let's see. I have to turn the store back on. Yes, of course. Yeah, that would make sense. The whole store was out of power. So let's turn that pump on, pump number 2. All right, so it should work now. Let's see. Wow, I didn't really put much in. I hope that's it's gonna last. All right, let's go here.
Carl knew straight away where to find the infuriated Gilles. Any good investigation would have to start there. Carl felt that the store and its surroundings still held their secrets, and he didn't like to miss out.
I'm not really sure where I'm supposed to go or if I can just go anywhere I want to. Let's see, it looks like I'm at the fork right here, and I think I'm just gonna continue here to the left and go to that first house that's on the map there, right on the lake, and see what's going on there. I'm pretty sure at the end I have to go check out all those properties and collect as much evidence as possible and see what really happened here. So far, I haven't met anyone yet, and I don't even know if there are any people or if I'm all by myself. So we're now in Western Otamapec, and this seems to be the first house that I saw on the map. Let's see what's going on here. Dr. Bopre's clinic. All right, see if that clinic is open. I'm gonna check his mail for him. Oh, there's a key. How convenient. I guess I have to let myself in. Take some log. Oh, and a fire starter. Make myself a nice little fire. So I don't think, what is this?
There should be a law forbidding doctors from falling sick.
Not so sure if I agree with that, but okay.
In spite of Dr. Beaupré's goodwill, the place didn't look much like a physician's office. It could easily be mistaken for a sewing shop.
Very weird. I don't see a light switch or anything. How is this doctor operating without light? But that's okay, I can see just enough to see if there's any evidence here.
The good doctor, flanked by his beautiful spouse. Pure happiness, captured on cardstock. Carl recognized this woman's soulful eyes. Was it Dr. Beaupré who had hit him head on at the village border?
He really thinks it could be the doctor that hit me? Unknown woman, I never did quite catch her name. The man called her Laurie. She had a neck wound. There was so much blood. The bullet had done a lot of damage, probably hitting the cerebellum. It was hopeless. She had a cardiac arrest. The man had found her like this, they said. I doubt it, but in a small town like this, it's usually best to turn a blind eye. Okay then.
Doctors used light-reflecting frontal mirrors to look inside the patient's cavities. That was a bit unsettling, but back then, it was pretty much always the case with medicine. A communist manifesto. Only a few years ago, this type of allegiance meant prison time. And even at present, the Western world was very wary of the Soviet threat. Why would the doctor own such a book? A chamber pot. Fortunately for Carl, inspecting it wouldn't further this particular investigation.
Ha, yeah, lucky me. What's in here? Oh, wait, there's something. A medkit. Great, now I have two. And a wine shelf. Store in a cool with a constant temperature, they said. Okay. Earth doesn't look like this big from here. The doctor's apparently fascinated with history. Alright, and some medical charts.
Carl got the trembles as he imagined the excruciating pain that kind of scalpel could no doubt inflict. Within these miserable walls, patients probably felt more like in a slaughterhouse than in a doctor's office.
Okay, I wouldn't really see it that way, but let's see, what does this do? Oh, I can fill up my bottle with water. Not so sure what I would need that for, but I guess everyone needs to drink plenty of water every day.
For the one-eyed, or for other vision problems, the eye patch was the way to go.
Wait, I have to attach a wire there, and I have no clue what kind of wire I have to attach. Matches? I bet you I have to find this wire somewhere. Hope it's in this house. Oh, more fire starters. Alright, let's go and make a fire here. Just in case. Yeah, it looks like my temperature was not quite normal. And my brain function wasn't quite up to normal. So let's heat up a little bit so we can think clearly. And see if we missed anything else. So I don't want to leave here without checking every little nook and cranny. Oh, yeah, I haven't checked down here yet. Doesn't look familiar to me. There's absolutely nothing. Oh, what's that? Let's go. Come on, I can't get to it. Let's close this.
The injured could be recognized by the large stains of red, an informal nickname given to Merbroman, smudged all over their injuries. Someone had lost a few liters of blood here. Carl's first thought had been a lumber accident, someone's hand cut by a saw, or a hunting accident. In any case, whoever had lost all this blood couldn't have gone far. Perhaps they were already dead.
Looks more like a head injury to me as it was on the pillowcase. Alright, just making sure I didn't miss anything. What's this? Not seen this. Okay, I've seen this. Oh, I haven't checked that yet. Oh, that looks like it's his wife's urn. Alright, a new journal entry. So let's go and see what's in the journal.
Carl, ever diligent in his work, always carried his log on him, in which he scribbled down thoughts and leads alike during the course of his investigations.
So I have some biographies of my client and the doctor in here, so not more. No photos yet. I think I have to take some more photos. I don't know where the other photos ended up that I took. Hamilton's murder. Oh, here's one of the photos. My client is dead. Everything is going wrong. All right, I just wrote down what I found at the general store here. What else is there? Let's go and check out the crash. All right. I don't remember having taken a photo of the crash scene. Not so sure. What's this? Okay, there's still some clues missing. Looks like there's lots of clues missing. The young woman. Huh, why is the photo there so dark? I can barely see it. Alright, but there's still some clues missing, it seems. And I still have to take more photos. That's pretty obvious. Lots of work cut out for me. And then we have the cold mystery here. I have to still take more photos of those weird blue ice thingies. Lots of more photos. And just find out more about them, I guess. Alright, I think we have the work cut out for us. I think I can pretty much say I searched this whole place. And I still have to attach that wire. God, I did not find it in this place. And this door is locked. I will have to go here. And I'm actually gonna search this property real quick just in case the wire is outside of this house somehow. All right. Maybe in this trash can. Oh, tape. Very good. Tape is always good. And empty beer bottle. Can't pick it up. Another beer bottle. Someone had a party here, looks like. Oh, what's this? A lantern. Well, that's a good thing.
Great care had to be taken searching this place full of oddities. Everything was important. The decor itself told a story.
Yeah, decor is funny. Looks like a mess here. Beer bottles everywhere, trash cans turned over, and some wolf paws, some tracks. Probably have to go and follow them, but I don't see them now. I'm kind of lost. Oh, here they are. Okay, let's go follow them. Usually they lead me to something good. Wait. It's kind of hard to see in this brush. God, they're just losing. Oh, here they are. Alright, let's go and follow them. I really hope I don't get lost. Okay, I totally lost track of those. Hopefully I see him here on the other side somewhere. Nope. Oh wait, here they are, and then they kind of go through this brush. God, I just can't find. Where did they go? Oh, here they are. Alright, oh, they go back in the brush. Oh, what do we have here? Some boxes. Guess that was cold. Guess I was supposed to find them. A flare. Okay. That's definitely a good find. And it doesn't look like the tracks go any. Oh, there's one more tape. But I think I don't have to go any farther here. There's a lake here. And I don't see any more tracks. Yeah, there's no more tracks, so I'm just gonna head back. God, I'm worried now about my temperature because I've been out for so long and it is really cold. And I think I'm lost. This doesn't look right. I'm gonna have to check my map. No, not the flashlight, the map. Okay, I'm on the right track.
It was so cold. Already Carl did not feel his toes anymore.
Oh, that's not good, but I should be back at my car pretty soon here, I hope. I can barely walk. Oh, here's my car. Okay, good. Thank God. I need to get in, warm myself up. Okay, just a few more steps. Alright, looks like my brain function has gone down quite a bit and I'm feeling better already. Okay, turn it off. I should probably go in a house and warm myself up. It doesn't seem like I'm getting warm in this car. I guess my heater doesn't work or something, so let's head up in the house and get ourselves warmed up at the fire. Oh, what's that? There's nothing there. Usually people hide keys underneath. Oh, this feels good. Look at that. My body temperature was at 50%. Oh, that feels so good. Alright, my body temperature is back to normal. And I still don't have anything to attach the wire. I just found a tape and a flare. I guess I have to find this wire somewhere else and come back to this house. Alright, I think I'm just gonna head to the next house, Old Roser, I think it's called. There's three more houses I can visit on this side of the lake. Here on the right anytime soon. Okay, must be this one here. Looks like an entrance. Let's go and check this out. Yep, that's the place I was trying to find. Curious to see what's going on in this house. There's some little shed over here of some sorts. I'm gonna check that out first. Oh, I need a key, of course. Let's see, there's no key hidden anywhere here. Or maybe here in the trash can. Nope. Fire starters. Oh, it's good, at least we have plenty of fire starters. And this is some kind of a deck, I guess. Some overlook deck. Nice. Let's see if I can find anything around this house before I go in. There's another trash can. Maybe there's the key in here. Nope, nothing. Betcha the key for this little house or shed is probably inside this house. Can I open this? Nope, some kind of wine barrel. Alright, there's some music in there. Maybe there's somebody home? Let's go and see. Okay, don't think I'm hurt, but he just shot me. Alright. Is he telling me to come in? Don't shoot me. Don't shoot me, please. I'm friendly.
Je m'attendais pas à ce qu'un étrange retentisse par ici. Moi te dire, je prends plus de chance depuis que ça rôde dans ce bout-là. J'ai ma carabine au bout du doigt, et puis bang, 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 si ça s'approche.
Man, you're a funny character, but you sure scared me.
Si tu veux du linge chaud, parce que t'es habillé comme un gars de la ville, je dirais pas non à une bonne bouteille de caribou. Puis tu pigeras ce que tu voudras parmi mes guenilles.
What the hell is caribou? If I knew, I would give it to you, but I never heard of it. I sure could use that coat, though.
C'est vrai, le jeune, que tu te promènes quasiment en bobette. Une bonne pelisse, ça te ferait pas de tort. Mais je vais te dire une chose. Dans ton coin de pays comme Palisette, on n'a rien sans rien. Et où, mon caribou?
All right, this guy is very talkative, but he doesn't seem to mind that I'm going into his drawers and stuff. Tales and legends.
C'est le Wendigo. Ouais, le Wendigo. Un guerrier qui devient un loup.
Okay, I guess he lets me search his place, so I'm just gonna continue. Still hoping to find this key for this shed.
La Corriveau.
Lots of books.
Marié, la Corriveau. À tuer tous ses maris. Squeak, les uns après les autres.
Yeah, okay, blah, blah, blah. Hey, at least he's friendly. Still has his shotgun, but...
Ça te passe l'envie de te marier, la Corriveau.
I guess I'm safe.
Squeak, les uns après les autres. Pas de pitié dans le mariage.
Okay. Where's your key? Where did you hide your key?
Ah, la belle pétarade. En 17 que c'était. Et le Kaiser, il se souvient de moi avec ma belle carabine. Bang, bang, que je lui disais. Bang, bang, bang. Ah, le bon temps.
He really doesn't want me to have the coat without getting some caribou, but I'm pretty sure I have to find out how to get caribou or how to make it. And maybe that's what the empty bottles are for that I've been collecting.
There, Carl had fed his mind, but had forgotten the harsh reality that his body also needed nourishment, especially in the dead of winter.
So nourishment means food, right? So I haven't seen any food, though. I'm supposed to eat food. All right, I'm gonna store this log in the back of my truck here. Let's see if we can deposit the log and any other things to kind of lighten my bag a little bit so I can collect more things. I don't need any cigarettes. I need hardware pliers, revolver. Yeah, I need that. Flare. Yeah, I should probably hold on to this. Duct tape. Yeah, I don't want to put anything more in the back of my truck in case I'm not with my truck and I need something of it to survive. Even though I have to make sure that I don't have too much stuff in my bag or I can't collect new things. So I think I'm just gonna head to the new house, which I have to go down this driveway and then to the right. Okay, let's continue this journey. I can barely see the road here, but I really don't want to end up in a ditch again. So it seems like... Ooh, I didn't mean to do that. Looks like I'm on the road right here, and I gotta go and turn to the right here carefully. Alright, okay, we're back on the road. And then the next property should be on the left, I think. Coming up here anytime soon. At least those houses are pretty close together. Oh wait, there's some blue eyes here on the right again. Pretty sure I'm supposed to inspect that, so let's go and let's see what's going on here. All right. Yep, that's one more of those blue stones. Let's take a photo of it. Add that to my journal. Keep the picture. Okay, and is there any more here? Okay, there are paws again. Looks like I'm supposed to follow those, so let's do this. See what we can find. Uh-oh, lost the... Oh, here they are. It's easy to lose those tracks in the brush. Ugh. I think I'm going way farther than I wanted to, but I'm really curious now to see where this goes. If I'm lucky, there is a fire pit somewhere where I can warm myself up. Wow, they go far. But I'm already so far, so I'm just gonna continue. And hope that I will find something soon here. Oh my god. This is never ending. Where's this go? Okay, I see something right here. What is this? Some trailer. Oh, there's some good stuff here. Hardware. A log. Oh, I'm just gonna take those logs, but I can't pick up the shovel and I can't pick up those pliers because I already have some. No wire though. Okay, I'm just gonna continue because those trucks... Oh, here we go, there's a fire, I should make one. Oh, that feels good. And since we were able to save the game right here, I think I'm gonna continue another time and call it quits for part 2. And I hope I see you next time when we play part 3.